Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we will learn how to install Apache Kafka on Windows. And we'll do some changes in its configuration file. And then we will see how to create the topics and how producer will send the message. And then consumer will consume the same message from the topic. That all we will see in this video. Okay, let's start to download the Apache Kafka. So first we need to go to browser, and here we will type Apache Kafka download and click on the first link, download Apache Kafka, and here we will download its latest version. So here we will click on 2.13. And here we will click on this link, then download will be start. Okay, so once the download is complete, go to download folder and extract this file here. So here I will select extract here. And after extracting, we will open it, and we can see here it contains bin folder, config folder and libs folder. So we will just copy this, or we can cut from here and go to our C drive and paste here in C drive. And we can rename this also and use its name as a Kafka. So now I will open it, and here we can see bin folder, and bin folder contains the all SSH files, and for Windows it contains these all bat files. Bat means batch file. These all files will be used for Windows. Then we will run the zookeeper and will start the Kafka server, then these files will be used. And config file contains, config folder contains all configuration properties file. So here we will do some changes. First we will open Kafka zookeeper.properties file. So click edit with notepad plus. And here we will see data directory folder is temp folder. So here we will change it from temp to C drive Kafka folder. And this will be zookeeper logs, and save it and close it. Now go to server.properties and edit with notepad plus, and here we will go and check the logs folder. So here it's also containing temporary folder, and we will change this folder, and here we will use C Kafka Kafka logs. And now close it. And the third one is libs folder, that contains all the library related to zookeeper and Kafka. So now I will go to our bin folder, and then we'll go to Windows folder, and here we need to start first zookeeper, then we can start only Kafka server. So to run zookeeper server, so first here I will click and type cmd. Now here I am inside Kafka bin Windows folder, and here I will type the command that will be used to run our zookeeper. So here I will type zookeeper server.batch file, and here I will type Kafka, and it is the my folder. Here it contains config folder inside Kafka and zookeeper dot properties file, it will read while running. So now I will click on enter. So it's saying zookeeper dot server dot bat file is not available. Okay, then I will go, and here we need to add zookeeper dot server dot start and enter. Now our zookeeper will start. And after starting the zookeeper, we can only start Kafka server. So here we kill allow access. Now I will go to again same folder, minimize it, and here we can see our Zookeeper has started. Now I will click, and now we need to run our Kafka server because our Zookeeper has already started. So here I will type Kafka server start, Kafka server start dot bat file, and its property file path is c slash kafka and slash config, and inside config it contains server dot properties file that contains its configuration. So click enter. Now here we can see Kafka has started. Now what we need to do, now we will create some topics. So here again I will click cmd and click enter, and now I will create few topics in our Kafka server. So here I will type Kafka topics dot bat and hyphen hyphen create, and here I will use Zookeeper and its localhost port that is defined inside its config file. Zookeeper localhost port is 2181, port is 2181, and replication factor will be used 1. Replication factor here we are using 1, and then its partitions that will be 1, and here we will define the topic name. So the topic name will be any name we can give. So here we will give test topic and click enter. So here we can see created topic test topic, and then we will create one more topic like test topic 2. So topic created, and here we can see two topics are created. Now if we want to check the list of all topics, then we will type Kafka topics.batch and hyphen hyphen list, and then Zookeeper and its port, Zookeeper localhost 2181. So here we can see list of topics that we have created. So here we can see two topics, test topic and test topic 2. Now what we will do, we will create one console producer. We will open one console producer and we'll send the message to this topic. And then we will create one more console that will be act as a consumer, that will consume all the message from its producer. So here, go here and click cmd and enter. And now first I will create console producer. So to generate console producer, here I will type Kafka console producer batch. So producer will produce the message and consumer will consume it. And here I will type broker hyphen list, broker list, and localhost port is, default port is 9092. And we can change it, go to its server.properties file, hyphen hyphen topic, and our topic name is test topic. So now the producer will send the message to this topic, test topic. Now here I will click enter. So here our producer console is created. Now I will go to my folder again, and here I will generate Kafka consumer console also. So both will be used at same time. So here I will type Kafka hyphen console and consumer dot bat file bootstrap hyphen server, and its default port is 9092 and the topic name that we have created, and producer will send the message to this topic only, test topic. And if you want to get all the message from beginning, then here I will type from beginning, from hyphen. Now click enter. So here this is our Kafka console and consumer console. And this is a producer console and this is a consumer console. So once I will send the message from producer, then consumer will consume this message. So here I will type hi. Then we can see here on consumer screen also the message hi is printed. Hope you are doing well. So here we can see this message because consumer is consuming this topic, test topic. So this is a producer console and this is a consumer console. Okay, this is all about how to configure and create the topics and send the message from producer and how the consumer will consume these all messages that we have covered in this video. In this video, we will see how to publish a message to Kafka topic with Spring Boot application. So okay, let's get started. So first what we will do, we will create one Spring Boot project. So here I will type start.spring.io and here we need to choose project type is Maven project and language Java and Spring Boot version. Here I have selected 2.3.4 and here we need to define artifact ID. So here I will type Kafka producer. And the next thing, we need to add the dependencies. So here I have selected Java 8 and click on add and just type web. Then we need to select Spring Web and the next dependency that we need to add is Apache Kafka, that is Spring for Apache Kafka, and next that is Lombok. So no need to write any setter getter method for our model classes and click on generate. Now go to show in folder and extract this file here and open this folder, copy the path, go to Eclipse and click on file, import existing Maven project and browse, then finish. Now we can see here our project is imported successfully. Now what we will do in this video, we will just create a Kafka producer and this producer will send model object. Like we will create one user model and this model will be goes to our Kafka topic and data will be write into Kafka topic. Then consumer will consume these messages that we will see by using Kafka console. And in the next video, we will also create Kafka consumer demo with Spring Boot application. Now here we will create one model class that we will send as a message. So here I will create new class that is user and we'll create one more package that is model and finish. And here I will add the annotation that is data and also use all our constructor and @ no arg constructor. And here I will define properties private int user ID and private string user name. And here I will use @ json properties. And here I will define the name for this property is like user ID. And @ username. Here I will define the JSON property name that is username. So here I have added two properties, and here I will use @ json include, and json include non null. Now I will create one more model class that will be the parent for all model classes. So here I have created message, and @message class I will use @data annotation and here I will declare one property that is common for all model, instant and time create. So now what we need to do next, thing we need to define the Kafka producer configuration. So here I will create one more package, that is config package, and we also need to create the controller, but first we will create Kafka producer config. So here I will create one class Kafka producer config, and here in this class we will define @bean annotation and will create the bean for producer config. So here I will define just method that is public map of string, and here I will just pass the object, and the function name is producer configs. And here I will just copy this map from here, and here I will create map that is props is equal to new hash map, and here we need to add props dot put, and here we need to add key. So key will be producer config dot, first we will use bootstrap key, and here we need to define Kafka host where is our Kafka is running. So first we need to start our Kafka. So here I will go to C drive, and inside C we have Kafka, and go to bin windows, and just here I will type cmd, and here we need to start first zookeeper, then we can start Kafka server. So here I will just paste the command here and click enter, then our zookeeper server will be start. After starting the zookeeper, now we need to run our Kafka server. So now I will go again to Windows cmd, and here we need to type the command that will run our Kafka server, Kafka server start dot bat, and click enter. Now our Kafka server has started. So now I will minimize this, and here I will define our private string Kafka host is equal to localhost 9092. So now I will copy this Kafka hosts and paste as a bootstrap server config, and next we need to add props.put, and here I will copy this producer config, and here we need to define key serializer class config. So here I will use string serializer class, string serializer from. So here I will just paste all the properties. So here I have just paste it, and now I will change it Kafka hosts as a name. Now what the next thing we need to create the bean for our producer factory. So here I will just paste it. So here after creating the bean for producer factory, also will create the bean for Kafka template. And this message class is our model class, so we need to import this message. So Kafka producer model message and save it. Now what we need to do, now we need to send the message from our controller. So here I will create one controller class. So first I will create one package, that is controller, and from this controller I will send the message and will be published to our topic. So here I will class one class, that is message controller, and here I will define the annotation, that is at the rest controller, and here I will create one endpoint that will be used to send the message, public user send user details. Here I will use at the rate request body, user return user service. So I need to create one more package, so here I will create one more package, that is service layer, and inside service layer I will create one more class, that is service package, and here I will create one more class, message service. And here I will define annotation, that is at the rate service. Now I will go to my controller back, that is message controller, and here I will auto void and inject the dependency. So here I will use auto void, and private message service, that is service. Now here I will call service dot send user and will pass the object of user, and here it showing create method. So here I will create one method, and here I need to inject dependency of Kafka template so I can send the message to our Kafka topic. And Kafka template, so here we just need to create the bean for Kafka template, and here I will call Kafka template dot send, and here I will select the topic and message data. What is the topic name that we need to use? So here I am just creating one string, private string topic, that is my topic. So it will be final. Just copy this topic and paste it here, and user data will be sent to our topic. And now it's showing change user to message. So here we need to check our user class is not extends message class. So first we will extends message class here, that is Kafka producer model. So here we have extended this class, that is parent class for all the classes. Now I will go and see here, it's not returning any message. So I will return the user model from here. Now we have done each and everything. Now I will just run this application. So first we need to create one topic, that is Kafka topic. So here I will go and will create topic, that's name will be my topic. So here I will just paste this command to create the topic, and here we can see our topic is created. Created topic, that's name is my topic. Now I will open console for my topic, and here I will paste the command, and this command will open the Kafka console consumer. So when the producer will produce the message, the all message will be, we can see here, because it's consuming the same topic, that is my topic, and we will publish the message to my topic. So now we will run this application, run as Java application. And here we can see our application has started. Now I will open to Postman. Now here what we need to check, first we will go to our message controller, and here we need to add post mapping, and here we can define URL for this, that is user. Okay, now I will stop and run again, run as Java application. Now our application has started. Now I will go to Postman, and here I have defined the URL, and in body I have just passed the raw value. So here I have defined the user ID is 1 and username is Karan. So now I will click on send. Then here we can see it will return the response. But it's showing some internal, and here we can see it's showing java.lang class cast exception cannot be cast to model into string. So here I will go to our Kafka producer config, and here we just need to add the annotation, that is @ configuration. So now I will stop it again and run this application again, run as Java application. Application has started. Now I will go to my Postman and will hit the same URL again, and here we can see that is the response, user ID 1 and username is Karan. Now we will go to Kafka console consumer, and this is the Kafka console consumer. There we can see the message that we sent from our API. So if I will change, so here I will send ID is 14 and name is Mohit, and click on send, and now I will go to our consumer, and here we can see the message. So I will just like this, and we'll send third message GGG, and this is our Kafka console, and click on send, and we can see here third message is also printed. And today in this video, we are going to create a simple Kafka consumer, and this consumer will consume the message from Kafka topic, and that message will be published from the Kafka producer. In this video, we'll demonstrate how to process the reports or messages from a Kafka topic with Kafka consumer. And in the previous video, we have created a simple Java example that creates a Kafka producer. We also created a replicated Kafka topic called my topic. Then we used a Kafka producer to send the records to Kafka topic. Now the consumer will create to consume those messages produced by Kafka producer. So okay, let's get started. So first I will go to browser, and here I will open star.spring.io to create a Spring Boot project. So here I will select the project type is Maven project, and language is Java, and Spring Boot version is 2.3.4, and here group ID, and then artifact ID. So here I will write artifact ID is Kafka consumer, and the next we need to change. We can use any version of Java. Here I am using Java 8. So next, click on add dependencies. So first I will select Spring Web, and the next one is Apache Kafka, Spring for Apache Kafka. And after that, third one is Lumbo, that is used to generate getter setter. So we'll no need to write any setter getter if we are using Lumbo. And now click on generate, and here zip file is generated, show in folder, and extract here. Now open it and copy the path from here. Go to Eclipse, file, import existing Maven project, browse, and finish. So our project is imported successfully. Now what we need to do, we need to create a Kafka consumer, and we need to define the configuration for our Kafka consumer. So first here I will create, and we also need to create the model, and we will use same model that producer will use to send the message. So here I will just go, and in previous video we have created this example, that is Kafka producer. So I will copy the package that contain model classes, and we'll go to our Kafka consumer and we'll paste it here. So here we are using the same model classes that the producer will use to publish the message. First one is user class, that contains two properties, that is user ID and username, and second one, its parent class, that is message, that just create one property. And the next thing, we need to create Kafka listener. So here I will create new package, and inside this package I will create new class, that is Kafka message listener. So here it will be Kafka message listener. So here we have created new class, that is Kafka message listener. And at class level we will define the annotation, that is @KafkaListener. Kafka listener that is supported by Apache Kafka. And here we need to define ID, that will be the listener ID. So we can define any ID. So here I am just writing my listener. And the next thing, we need to define the topics. The listener will consumer will subscribe some few topics. So here we will create my topic, and consumer will subscribe this topic, that is my topic. Now if we will publish the message to my topic, then consumer will consume all the message that we will publish to my topic. And here I will define one method, that will be word type, and we'll print the message on console that we will get from topic. And here this is our model class, that is message. And here we will just print the output, reading messages from Kafka topic produced by, that is message. And here we need to import this model, that is our model class. And at this function we just need to define the annotation, that is @KafkaHandler. So this is our Kafka message listener class. Now we just need to define the configuration for our Kafka consumer. So here I will create new class. So new class, and here we just need to define the package name, that is the config package, and the class name will be Kafka consumer config. And here we have created Kafka consumer config. And one more thing that we need to, so here we have need to define application dot properties file some properties like we need to use server dot port because we will run two project. So one will be run on default port, that is Kafka producer will be 8080 and the consumer will be run on 9090. So next we will define Kafka host, that is localhost 9092 is its default port of Kafka server. And we will define Kafka group ID, that we will use this property in our Kafka config. So here we are just defining, and group ID we can give any group name, group 1. And here we will define Kafka listener threads, and that will be like 10. And we can also define Kafka session timeout, Kafka dot session dot timeout, and that will be, we can define millisecond 30,000, and we have defined this property. Now I will go to our Kafka consumer config and will use these properties there. So now I will just open it, and here I need to define the annotation, that is @configuration. So Spring Boot will read this class, and also need to define @enable Kafka. So Kafka will enable it, enable Kafka. And what we need to do first, I will define the properties. So these are the properties that we have defined our application.property file, and we are just reading these properties value. And next thing what we need to do, so first here we will create the bean for our consumer config that we have did in our producer also, Kafka producer. So here I will just define one method that will be public map, its return type, and it will return string is the key and value as object. And we need to define the function name, that is consumer config. And here we will just create this map. So here I will just create one hash map that will be props new hash map. So it will be java.util.maps, and here configs. And here I will return props, and now we need to set the values for all properties. Here we need to specify the bootstrap server, that will be our local Kafka server host address. So I will just paste all the properties value, and this will be the Apache Kafka Commons serializer that we will use, and ORG Spring Framework JSON deserializer. So here we just provide the configuration for our Kafka consumer. First one is bootstrap server config, and it will define the host address of Kafka server, that is localhost 9092 default. And second one is we have used key deserializer class config. It is just used to set the Kafka deserializer class, and it will be used to record key deserialize. And the second one is value deserializer class config is used to deserialize the value of record. And the next one is group ID config, that is used to identify the consumer group. And the next one is we have enable auto commit config is true. So automatically each message will be sent to topic and will be read by consumer. So here we just defined enable auto commit config in our consumer configuration. And here we have defined session timeout in milliseconds. We have defined 30,000 milliseconds. So after defining consumer configuration, now we will create consumer factory. In our Kafka producer, we create producer factory, but here we will create consumer factory. So here I will just declare one method, that is public कंज्यूमर फैक्ट्री दैट इज स्ट्रिंग द वैल्यू विल बी मैसेज एंड द फंक्शन नेम इज कंज्यूमर फैक्ट्री. So here we just need to import this model, Kafka producer model, and now here I will create and return new default Kafka consumer factory, new default Kafka consumer factory, and here we need to define few properties, that is consumer configs. Just copy from here and paste it here. And also we need to define new string deserializer that is supported by Kafka, and also new JSON deserializer that is also supported by Kafka. And here we just need to define our model class, that is the parent message dot class, and here we have created our consumer factory. And after creating the consumer factory, we need to create one more concurrent Kafka container consumer factory. So here I will declare at the rin bean annotation at function level, and next I will create the bean for concurrent Kafka listener container factory. And here in concurrent Kafka listener container factory, we just created the factory object and set these three values. The first one, we set the customer, set the consumer factory, and it contain consumer factory all configuration. Means it is used to specify a consumer factory to use, which consumer factory we want to use. And the second one is we use set call timeout. And the timeout, if we are not defining this property, then default it will be 5000 milliseconds. And it is used to set the max timeout to block in the consumer that is waiting for records or messages. And the third one is set concurrency, means how many consumer we want to create. So here we just define Kafka listener, it's a one integer value. In our application.properties file, we have defined its values 10. So it will create 10 consumers. And the next, we need to create one more bean for our Kafka message listener class. So here I will create public Kafka message listener that we have created, and function name will be Kafka message listener, and it will return new Kafka message listener. Kafka message listener. So here at function level, I will define annotation that is @bean. So our configuration is done for our Kafka consumer. Now we just need to run. But before running this application, we need to check our ZooKeeper server or Kafka server is in running state. So here I will go and go to C drive, Kafka bin, and inside Windows folder here we just need to start our Kafka server. So first I will start my ZooKeeper. So here I will just paste this command to start the ZooKeeper server. Now here we can see ZooKeeper is started. Now we need to start our Kafka server. So here I will just type cmd and we'll paste the command to run the Kafka server, and here we can see our Kafka server is running. So here we have two projects, one is Kafka consumer and second is Kafka producer. So first I will run my Kafka producer that will be used to publish the message to topic. Then Kafka consumer will be used to consume the message from that topic. So first I will run as a Java application to my Kafka producer application. एंड वेन द काफका प्रोड्यूसर विल बी स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट आई विल स्टार्ट काफका कंज्यूमर काफका प्रोड्यूसर हैज स्टार्टेड नाउ आई विल गो टू काफका कंज्यूमर मेन क्लास एंड इट विल रन ऑन पोर्ट 9090 सो हियर आई विल क्लिक रन जावा एप्लीकेशन एंड हियर वी कैन सी आवर बोथ एप्लीकेशन हैज स्टार्टेड काफका प्रोड्यूसर एंड कंज्यूमर So here we can see both application is running. So now I will go to my producer rest endpoint and here I will just send the message to our topic by clicking on send. Now here we can see message is published to our topic. Now I will go to console and check on my Kafka consumer console. So here we just need to check it again. Here it's showing some exception. Kafka consumer, the group member needs to have a valid member ID before actually entering into consumer group. So here I will go to my application.properties file and need to check it. If there is something wrong, 9090 server port, Kafka host, group IDs, group 01, Kafka listener threads. Now we'll go to my Kafka consumer config. And here we need to check Kafka listener.threads. It is the same. So here everything is looking fine. We just need to check Kafka listener ID is my listener. And I just try to replace with my listener. And here my topic name is my topic. So now I will stop my Kafka consumer application and rerun this application. Run as Java application. And now we'll check it again. So here our Kafka consumer application has started. Now we will just publish the message to the topic with the help of Kafka producer, our both application in running state. And in our Kafka producer, we have created one REST endpoint that will be used to publish the message. So then when the message will be published, the consumer will listen and consume this message. Now I will rerun this application. That is Kafka consumer application. And after starting the Kafka consumer application, we will check here. That is the group member needs to have a valid member ID. But we can then also send the message to topic. So go to postman and click on send. And check on the console. Here we can see reading message from the Kafka topic. And now we will send one more message. New user 234 and click on send. And here we can see user 234 is also printed. So like this we can send the message and publish message with the help of Kafka producer. And then we can consume this message from Kafka consumer. Okay. Then we have done everything Kafka producer and Kafka consumer. Okay, thanks for watching this video.